Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Caesar salad. And you might have guessed that we were going to do that, and there might have been a couple of hints along the way. When my husband Rick and I had our 40th wedding anniversary dinner at Beaumont Inn, his salad was a Caesar salad, and I mentioned at the time that I hadn't made one of those for you. And then the two uploads that preceded this one were of the cheese wafers that we had with that Caesar salad, and also croutons. So I was preparing you for the making of Caesar salad. So you might have guessed it was leading up to that. By the way, I do want to tell you how grateful Rick and I are to all of you for the comments that you made when I announced that I was going to take a break for our 40th wedding anniversary. And I left a little slideshow with you, and you had really sweet, kind comments to make about that slideshow. And then after the dinner that I uploaded, you also had wonderful comments for all of that. And I can't thank you enough. I probably will not be able to answer all of those, if any of those, because there were so many. But I want to thank you right now for everything that you said, and you do mean a lot to me. I really missed you. When I take a break, it's just not right. So I'm back. And we're going to start by making a sauce, which is actually going to be a salad dressing for our Caesar salad. Now, most of you know that Caesar salad that you order in a restaurant generally is made with raw egg and also has anchovies. And those are two spots that give me a little trouble, because I feel like, from feedback I've had previously on eggnog and some other things, you don't like to have things with raw eggs, so we're not going to do that. And also anchovies, I'm just going to say, those are optional. A lot of times when you order a Caesar salad, they'll be in there. You may not even know it, but it will give a certain flavor to it. And you may feel like that's missing in this, but I'm going to say it's optional. You can put it in if you want to. Here's what I'm going to do. It's going to be a mayonnaise-based dressing. And you know, mayonnaise is, if you make homemade mayonnaise, you make it with raw eggs and you whip it up and you use it just like that. But this would be pasteurized, because it comes packaged from your grocery store, and I'm using free mayo. So it helps a little bit on the calories and fat. We need 1 cup of mayonnaise. So measure that out. And then we need 1 tablespoon of lemon juice. And I always keep this in my refrigerator, because I don't always have fresh lemons to squeeze. So we're going to use 1 tablespoon of real lemon, or whatever brand this is, of lemon juice that you can buy at your grocery store. And then we're moving to Worcestershire sauce. I need 1 teaspoon. I'm sorry, that's one. No, it is 1 teaspoon. I looked at this and I thought, that's not right. But it is 1 teaspoon. 1 teaspoon of Worcestershire sauce. And then you see I've done a little cutting right here, because I have a clove of, this is a bulb of garlic, but if you take one of these pieces, it's called a clove of garlic, you need to take the skin off of it, and then you need to mince it very fine. So we have 1 minced garlic going in there. A little bit more here. Move that aside. And then we have salt. I need 1/4 teaspoon of salt. And then I need some fresh ground pepper. I've ground it already about 1/8 of a teaspoon. But you would just have your fresh peppercorns and crack that, and it just gives that lovely aroma coming up in the air. Now, this always has some cheese in it. It's generally Parmesan cheese that goes in it. I've chosen to put a blend here of Parmesan, Romano, and Asiago that comes in a can like this. Sometimes you'll find just Parmesan alone, and it will be much finer than this. This is sort of a shred instead of grated. But any of those will work. You need 1/2 cup of it. So if you want to use just a shredded Parmesan from your cheese department at the grocery store, that will be fine, 1/2 cup of that. Or if you have a block of it and you want to shred it yourself, 1/2 cup. Or if you have a blend like this, be perfect. It doesn't have to be according to the rule, because I'm not making a really standard form of a dressing for Caesar salad. This is kind of my form that I think will work for everybody. And I have one less ingredient here. Here's my milk, skim milk, and we need 1 tablespoon. So all of that's ready, and it needs to be mixed up. And this is when I usually get out my mixer, but today I'm going to use a blender. That this is a Hamilton Beach variety. You might have one of these and you might prefer to use something like this. So let me turn this on. I've got it plugged in. And just press this button. And I'm going to go ahead and get this all blended up and let you see what it looks like, and then we'll be chilling this for a while before we actually put the salad together. This hand blender has worked nicely to get the Caesar salad dressing to come together. You can see that there are some lumps in it. I like to leave it like that. If you want to go further with it, you could continue to blend. Actually, you could put this in an electric blender if you want to. You can use a mixer with it if you want to. I just thought that this was a really good use for the electric hand blender, and I would show that to you since I don't think I've had that in a video yet. But what we have here is Caesar salad dressing. So if you want to, you could put it in a jar, a clean jar with a lid, and just refrigerate it and use it on any salad that you want. But we're going to go ahead and make Caesar salad. So what I need to do is cover this with some plastic wrap, put it in the refrigerator, and chill it. And after it's chilled and I'm ready to make my salad, then I will get all the ingredients for the salad together and show you my Caesar salad. We're ready to assemble our Caesar salad. So I want to show you, you need 1 head, well actually just 1/2 head of romaine lettuce. This is half, and the other half, actually I've probably got just 1/4 in here because I was making this for Rick and me, but you'd probably be making it for more people. So probably 1/2 head and a large enough bowl to take care of it. What you're gonna add in is some Parmesan cheese that is shredded finely. You can see that this is finely shredded Parmesan cheese that is already comes in that package. If you can't find it like that, then you can shred your own, but make it pretty fine. And I measured out 1/2 cup, but for the amount I have here, I think probably 1/4 cup would do it. So if you had a large bowl and plan to serve 4 to 6 people, then maybe 1/2 cup. We'll come back to that anyway. Then you have the croutons that we made earlier. And I had them cooling, so they're all cool. I've got 1/2 cup measured out, but to this bowl, probably don't need that much. Really, all of this is just by eyesight. Then go to your dressing and just put a couple of big globs on the top, and then you're going to toss that. So I'll come back when I've got it tossed, let you see what it looks like, and we'll go from there. I've got this Caesar salad all tossed up, and this is the point that you would have added your anchovies before the tossing of this if you wanted those. And you need a nice salad plate or bowl, it doesn't matter, and you're just going to lift from your larger bowl and bring over all of that good stuff as much as you want for one serving. And then it's nice to just kind of replicate what you have done by putting a sprinkling of Parmesan cheese over the top of that. Makes it look really nice and it adds to the flavor. And then put some of those crunchy croutons that have not had any soaking in dressing, although these haven't really soaked. This is very freshly made. And then remember those wafers that we made, those cheese crisps. Take a couple of those if you want, and put one on each side of the plate, and there's your lovely Caesar salad.